Let's think about another scenario that we can model with differential equations. And this is a scenario where we take an object that is hotter or cooler than the ambient room temperature, and we want to model how fast it cools or heats up. And the way that we'll think about it is the way that Newton thought about it, and it is Newton's described as Newton's law of cooling. And in a lot of ways, it's common sense. It states that the rate of change of temperature should be proportional to the difference between the temperature of the object and the ambient temperature. So let me write that in mathematical terms. So Newton's law of cooling tells us that the rate of change of temperature, I'll use that with a capital T, with respect to time, lowercase t, should be proportional to the difference between the temperature of the object and the ambient temperature. So that is a mathematical description of it. And once again, it's common sense. If something is much hotter than the ambient temperature, the rate of change should be pretty steep. It should be declining in temperature quickly. If something is much cooler, it should be increasing in temperature quickly. And if something is close, well, maybe if these two things are pretty close, maybe this rate of change shouldn't be so big. Now, I know one thing that you're thinking. It's like, okay, if the temperature is hotter than the ambient temperature, then I should be cooling. My temperature should be decreasing. And a decreasing temperature would imply a negative instantaneous change. So how will this be a negative value in the case where our temperature of our object is greater than our ambient temperature? And the way that that would happen is you would have to have a negative k. Now, if you don't like thinking in terms of a negative k, you could just put a negative right over here, and now you would have a positive k. Now, it makes sense. If our thing is hotter, if it has a higher temperature than the ambient temperature, so if this is a positive, then our rate of change will be negative. We'll be getting cooler. If it was the other way around, if our temperature of our object is cooler than our ambient temperature, then this thing is going to be a negative. But then the negative of that is going to be a positive. We're assuming a positive k, and our temperature will be increasing. So hopefully this makes some intuitive sense. And our constant k could depend on the specific heat of the object, how much surface area is exposed to it, or whatever else. But now, given this, let's see if we can solve this differential equation for a general solution. And I encourage you to pause this video and do that, and I will give you a clue. This is a separable differential equation. So I assume you've had a go at it. So let's now work through it together. So we just have to algebraically manipulate this so all my t's and dt's are on one side. Or I should say, so all my capital T's and d capital T's are on one side. And this is going to be a little bit more confusing because I have a capital T and a lowercase t. Capital T for temperature, lowercase t for time. But hopefully we'll be able to work through it. And then I'm going to have all my time differentials and time variables on the other side. So one thing I could do is I could divide both sides by capital T minus ambient temperature, minus T sub A. Remember, this is just going to be a constant based on what our ambient temperature is. We're going to assume our ambient temperature doesn't change as a function of time, that it's just such a big room that our cup of tea is not going to actually warm up the room. So that's just one of these assumptions that we're going to make. So if we do that, if we divide both sides by this, we are going to have, so I'm going to divide both sides, let me do this in a new color. If I divide both sides by that, I get 1 over capital T minus T sub A, and let me multiply both sides times the time differential. So I'm going to have, so that dt, so our temperature differential times our temperature differential is going to be equal to negative k times our time differential. So once again, to separate the variables, all I did is divide both sides by this and multiply both sides by that. Now I can integrate both sides. We've seen this show before. So I can integrate both sides. And the integral of this is going to be the natural log of the absolute value of what we have in the denominator. And you could do u substitution if you want. If we said u is equal to capital T minus T sub A, then du is just going to be 1 dt. And so this is essentially you could say the integral of 1 over u du. And this would be the natural log of the absolute value of u. And this right over here is u. So this is the natural log of the absolute value of capital T minus T sub A is equal to, and once again, I could put a constant here, but I'm going to end up with a constant on the right-hand side too. So I'm just going to merge them into the constant on the right-hand side. So that is going to be equal to, now here, this is going to be negative kt, and once again, we have plus c. And now we can raise e to both of these powers, or another way of interpreting this is that e to this thing is going to be the same as that. So we can write this as the absolute value, let me do that in that same blue color. We can write this as the absolute value of t minus t sub a is equal to e, something about e, I always think of the color green, e to the negative kt plus c. This, of course, is the same thing as this is equal to e to the negative kt. We've done this multiple times before. Negative kt times e to the c times e, let me do that in that same, so times e to the c power. And we could just call this, well, we could just call this another arbitrary constant. Let's see, if we call this c1, then we could just call this whole thing c. So this we could say is c e to the negative kt. So at least it's starting to resemble what we did when we were modeling population, but we see it's a little bit different. Instead of just temperature on this left-hand side, we have temperature minus our ambient temperature. And so we can do a couple of things. If in a world, say where we're dealing with a hot cup of tea, something that's hotter than the ambient temperature, so we could imagine a world where tea is, let's say, greater than or equal to our ambient temperature. So that means this is hot, or it's hotter, I guess we could say. So if we're dealing with something hotter than the ambient temperature, then this absolute value is going to be positive, or the thing inside the absolute value is going to be positive. So we don't need the absolute value, or the absolute value of it's going to be the same thing as it. And then we could just add TA to both sides, T sub A to both sides, and then we would have our temperature, and I could even write this as a function of time, is going to be equal to this business, is going to be equal to CE, let me do that in the same color, CE to the negative kt plus T sub A, All I did is I'm assuming that this inside the absolute value is going to be positive, so the absolute value is not going to change the value, and I added T sub A to both sides to get this. So this right over here is going to be our general solution in the case where we start with something that is hotter than the ambient room temperature. And if we want to look at the case where something is cooler than the ambient room temperature, so that's the situation, let's say T is less than our ambient room temperature, then the absolute value of T, then this thing over here is going to be negative, and so the absolute value of it is going to be the negative of that. So then this up here results in T sub A minus T, that's going to be the same thing as the absolute value. It's going to be the negative of the negative. So then that is going to be equal to, E to the negative K, let me do that. Actually, I'll do it in the same color. I think you get the point. Negative KT plus, actually, let me just do it. T sub A minus T is going to be equal to C E to the negative kt, so this is equal to that. I'm just assuming that t is less than t sub a. And so then to solve for t, you could add t to both sides and subtract this from both sides. You would have capital T as a function of t is going to be equal to, let's see if this went onto that side and this goes over here, you would just have the, you would have t sub a minus c e to the negative kt. Did I do that right? So yep, that looks right. So this is the situation where you have something that is cooler than the ambient temperature. So this right over here, based on the logic of Newton's law of cooling, these are the general solutions to that differential equation. Now, in the next video, we can actually apply it to model how quickly something might cool or heat up.